Hello everyone, Kelly Cow Divine here playing Football Manager 2018. The beta just came out a few hours ago. I've been playing a little bit. You can see this is the beta version down here. What else? Yeah, I played with Villarreal. Didn't really go that well. I played up to the first competitive game. It was in the league against Barcelona. We lost 3-0. It was not a pleasant experience, that match. But now we are gonna get into this for real. I set up a poll that I've been spreading a little bit. 24 people voted, and I picked 4 teams that are new to... Actually, we can go here. The Europe, England, and Vanarama's North and South. 4 teams that are new. There are 6 teams that moved up from the lower divisions to North and South. And I picked so people could vote between Spennymoor, Leamington. Let me think for a little bit. Chippenham Town, of course, and Blyth Spartans. And 4 people voted for Leamington, 4 people voted for Chippenham, 5 people voted for Spennymoor, and then Blyth got 11 votes. So that is the team we will go with. We're gonna do advanced setup. I guess I'm not really sure why I picked the Brazilian league. That is fine. That Portuguese league, not really a big deal, and since I am from Sweden, I guess we can go first division and above. We will add more nations, more leagues from other nations once we are higher up in the English division system. If we manage to get that far, we'll see what happens, and we're gonna start early here. I guess that is fine. And we see the speed should be okay. Maybe we can, we can go with that. Start the game. So let's do that. That is not a very skilled trainer. Not a very skilled manager. We can't really train our players in anything. I guess we should focus on one thing here. Not attack. Let's do that at one. Defending and tactical training will be our focus, even if we are super bad at it. Determination, level of discipline, motivating, man management. Hopefully we can improve these stats later on. Start playing. There we go. That will be the save file we use. We have arrived. We have been hired by Blyth Spartans. Attend meeting. Welcome to Spartans. I'd like to take a few minutes of your time to welcome you to the club before handing over to your assistant manager, who is going to discuss staff responsibilities with you. I also want to assure you that you have the full backing of the board, and we wouldn't have hired you if we didn't feel that you were the right person to propel the club forward. You didn't pick me, I picked you. Would you like me to help you with any tasks at the club? I'm gonna set that up myself later on. Injuries, none at the moment. Responsibilities, we will have a look at that. We will need to see what kind of people we have at the club first. A background. Founded in 1899, Spartans are a semi-professional English club currently playing in the Vanarama National League North. Won the Northern Premier League title last season, and that is why they moved up now to this division. The club play their home games at Croft Park and possesses basic training facilities and poor youth facilities. The club also has basic junior coaching and a limited youth recruitment network. Hopefully, we can improve junior coaching, youth recruitment, and youth facilities. But I also know that sometimes that can be difficult at this level. Difficult to get money, difficult to get the board to use the money as I want them to to be used. But we will see what happens. Maybe the board here is amazing. Tony Platten is the chairman. So we will have a look at that later on, I guess. Holloway presents Blyth report. Overall depth is very low. Goalkeeper depth, defense, work rate, strength, teamwork, first touch, passing. We have a lot of negatives. But midfield, Jarrett Rivers is a good one. Nathan Buddle is a good one. Introductory advice summary. Let's look at the board first here. We can see if we have any money. 242,000 euro. I'm playing with euro, not with pounds. Sorry about that. If anyone do not like me playing in the English system with a euro instead of a sterling pound. It would be nice if they would improve this. But I am too new at the club for them to want to discuss that. That makes sense. We're not gonna bother with vice captain or captain at the moment. Free kick takers, we are not really. We're gonna have a look at that ourselves later on. Okay, think we are fine with that. Chief Scout Martin, nice to have a Chief Scout. We are going to make use of him. The Scouting Center is where you will receive recommendations and reports for players. Scouting Center is new to this game. I had a little bit of a look at it. I'm not really sure if I am a big fan yet. If we go here, they're coming with recommendations here. Okay, keep scouting. I guess we only had one player there. I like the old system here when we can have a lot of options here and we can click them and unclick them. Now we need to go into this one instead. Feels like. Yeah, I'm not really sure if it's the way I would like it, but I guess we will get used to it. We will learn to live with it. The dynamics is, of course, also new. And should have a decently big impact of the game. My worry is that they will complain a lot, but we will see if that actually happens. Here we see the social groups. These are the leaders, are the core social group, secondary social group. Okay, that makes sense. Hierarchy, I am the manager, I'm at top, and then we have the team leaders. Okay. Not sure if I will take this into consideration now at the start, but I guess we will find that out eventually. Okay, this is a good screen. Happiness. And you can. Yeah, if you lose the if you lose the t some players on the team, if one of the team leaders become unhappy, it is more likely it will spread to other players on the team. If someone here at the lower parts is unhappy, I guess it is not as likely it will spread to other people. Something like that. We will see that later on, I guess. We're gonna have a look at the team a little bit. We can see I have set up my own view here. Maybe I will need to edit it later on. We actually have the wage here that can be useful when we come into a new club. We can see what other people on the team are making, and then when we offer contracts to other players, we don't want to go higher than the highest paid, at least. Doesn't really look like anyone is super high paid, so that's fine. Current ability, potential ability, both are good to keep an eye at. This is a tricky decision to make. 4-4-2, I guess, would be decent. How are we gonna go 4-4-2? Or should we do 4-3-3 with wingers? We have decent wingers, but then we do not have three people. Nope, we need to do 4-4-2. So let's go into tactics. There we have it. They have moved a few things here. We see other new things. Medical center. We already had the report that we do not have any injuries. And now the secondary teams are down here. And we have the report bug because this is the beta version. But now let's go into tactics. We can see this is also changed. We can ask assistant, but we're gonna create new tactic. And we're just gonna go with 4-4-2. What the hell did I click? I think I clicked here. Yes, team instructions is here. Flexible, standard. I guess standard and flexible. I want to actually play structured. I feel like that is a good for a weak team like ours. We're gonna change the tactics a little bit later, but let's look at the media prediction. 17th place out of 22 teams. That means we should have a decent chance at being safe this season. Decided on the tactics. Let's go with assigning the team here. Goalkeeper Sean McDonald. Right defender. We decided on Andrew Cartwright. And we should have Nathan Buddle and Ryan Hutchinson, Michael Liddle. Let's actually go back to tactics. If we do that, I feel like we need to do this because that is where our wingers were strongest. Okay, central midfielders, Louis Horner, of course, and Dale Hobson. What kind of, okay, Cariello, that is a new role. And Dave McTiernan, central defender, defend. And Louis Horner, your best one was Messala. I do not really know what Messala does. Let's move back to tactics. We need to figure out what Messala is all about. This is the modern interpretation of the Messala, a central player that likes to drift wide and operate in half spaces. The Messala is essentially a central half winger who likes to do his defending slightly further up the field, although he does generally have less defensive responsibility. Maybe we should do. That was not correct. Do this. Cariello, the Cariello or a shuttler is a supporting role more often than not utilized as part of a midfield three or as two central midfielders in a diamond midfield. It is the job of these shuttlers to cover lateral areas of the pitch and link the defensive midfield area with the attacking midfield area. This is what separates the Cariello from a box-to-box midfielder, as they are not expected to shuttle between boxes, but merely between lines of the midfield. Doesn't really sound like it would be a good option for us, since we are not playing that way. The suitability indicator shows how well suited a player is. Okay, that makes sense. I guess we can go with Messala and maybe central midfielder defend. And if you go with central midfielder defend, it looks like Dave McTiernan was the better option. And Dale Hobson will be the first option on the bench. We're also gonna put that goalkeeper on the bench. Jordan Watson will be on the bench as well. Right midfielder, Jarrett Rivers. Left side will be Robbie Dale. And we will need Sean Reed. No, Adam Wrightson to be the the backup there, Sean Reed. He's also capable as a central midfielder. That will be useful, I guess. No, he will be on the bench as well for now. And then the attackers, we only have two decent options. Sean Reed, how capable were you? Not very capable, but that will be fine. So, what do we feel that we need here? Let's look at the under 20, only one player, Jack Butler. He's a striker. Okay, looking at this, I would feel like an attacker with maybe 3 stars ability, higher potential would be awesome. Same thing with the central defender. Those are the two positions that really need to be filled. Dale Hobson, you can cover that, yep. So if you sign any players, that is what we are aiming for, an attacker and a central defender. Let's look at the board here. So we can see that we have a little bit of wage budget to work with and a little bit of transfer budget as well. Would not like to use the transfer budget, so against wage budget would be the best option. That means we need to start scouting. First thing first, actually we can have a look here. I did say earlier that we had a chief scout, but no other scouts. That means we want to hire 2 more scouts, because I usually like to rely quite heavily on scouts. Staff role, scouting, there we go. Employed, no. And the attributes, judging player ability, player potential. I hope that is good enough. And 15, I doubt we can get anyone that good. Let's do 11. Okay, not. I think we can see. Yes, we can see when they show up there. So that is at least good. That is helpful. Paul Cartman, 10-9. We're going to have a look at them. I could change the view here to see, but we're going to do this for now. Okay. Paul Cartman, we would like to have you. How much would you like to have be paid? Feel like that is a little bit too much. Let's do 170. We can do 170. And there we go. Didn't really look that carefully at the others. They all had judging player potential 9. Can have a look at adaptability. I guess Tyler Spence would be a good option if he agrees to 170. He's going to be difficult, but he will come, at least from what it looks like now. So we have the staff coming in. We're going to have a look at responsibilities. Oh, he actually is setting the assignments. Did I change that already? I don't think so. We are not going to manage the friendly matches. Maybe we should manage the first 1 or 2 friendly matches, and then we're going to have the assistant manager take over. Okay, we have a decent start here to our journey with the Spartans. Squad dynamics introduction. I know that many of you may not have heard of me, so I wanted to personally introduce myself to you as the new Blyth manager. And they are happy. I'm very positive about our chances, and I think we go on and make the playoffs this season. Nope. 17th place is where we are predicted, so I'm gonna be very positive about our chances, and I think we can beat the drop and stay in this division this season. They are super happy about that. So another new thing, pre-match tactical briefing, reminder, handle briefing. We can have the assistant manager do it, but let's do it. We need to check this out. Talk to team, hand over to assistant, stop briefing. Okay. Oh, we could change this. This is not that bad, I guess. Talk to team. Formation 4-2-4 wide. I think our 4-2-4 wide formation will work best today. Oh, see, a lot of people were happy about that. Mentality standard. Since we are playing the youth team, let's go with attacking. People are happy about that. Structured. We are low on creativity right now, so a structured shape would benefit us. They didn't really care either way about that. What else can we say? We can talk to the people. Let's do it to one person, Dan McGuire. Take more risks with your passing today. We'll need you to. Try to hold up the ball here. Oh. Try to hold up the ball here. Didn't really have an impact. We can talk to people, but I feel like this is a bit uncertain at the moment, so we are not going to bother with it. And let's have a little bit more look at the tactics. We see that we can go with the winger attack here on Dale Rivers. He's gonna be support, he's best at that. Let's do that. Let's see what kind of impact that will have. Advanced forward is the best position for Maguire. And target man is the best position for Rutherford. Actually, let's do that and then move them. Because I usually like my more defensive player to be on the right side here up. There we go. And the defensive player in the midfield to be on the left side. That is just how I am used to doing things. It's not a big deal. I think a little, if you want to play as a defensive fullback, we can allow you to do that. We do not really have a grasp at what works and not in Football Manager 2018. So we can have both as defensive fullbacks, actually. Defensive center back, stopper. Cover. Let's do cover. And you can do defend instead. So the cover is very far back. Maybe we should do then stopper that is a bit more forward. So he will try to stop the ball. He will try to cover. Maybe that is a good solution for us. I feel like we're ready. We are playing against our under 18 team should be an easy match, but you never know. You never know with Football Manager. Not sure if anything else will happen before that match. I think we're gonna have a look at that match actually the whole way. So I will see you when that match starts. I think we are ready to start the match. I have no idea. Let's push forward into the match. Some new screens should be coming up here as well. This one is new. We can see they are warming up, but we get to see a few things here instead. The Rutherford is the only one with his picture in the game. And then the game moved on to the dressing room. Hand over to assistant, talk to team. Most of the players appear completely disinterested in what you have to say, despite a generally fair atmosphere overall. Okay, this is also a bit new, but I guess the same. A few more options, but basically the same. Since they didn't want to listen, they seem disinterested. I'm gonna go with assertive. I'm gonna say we're favorites for a reason, and they didn't really care about that, but maybe that is because we are playing the under 18 team and they do not really care. I guess we can go into kickoff. players are walking out, they are standing there waiting, and we are starting. We start with the ball, Rutherford. Rivers, we're gonna have a look here as well. Actually, this stats, I think I did mark match stats, okay. But okay, now it is marked, and we also want the league to be shown, but we are not playing league matches now, so we can't pick that at the moment. How are the stats? The stats are in our favor, but they should be, but no shots fired after 5 minutes of play. Let's have a look at this director camera. Sounds is off. That is always nice. I turn them off. Camera height, camera zoom. Okay, that's pretty cool that it can be changed. We can see the under 18 are pushing forward. Are they gonna get the first chance of the match? No, we steal the ball. Rutherford to Maguire, and Maguire should kick ass in a match like this. But instead it is Dale, and that is a corner kick. As I said, it's going a little bit slow. Match speed during highlights. Let's push that forward a little bit to that. Match speed between highlights. Let's move that to very fast. Notification, show for 4 seconds. Replays. I guess we could get, I think we will get replay options when we are in a replay. Rivers. Oh, a goal. I feel like it's going a little bit too fast now. We're going to move it down one step, slightly faster. You can see on the replay here, Maguire. Cartwright to Rivers, and just before the line, he will find Maguire in the middle, and we have the first goal of the season, even if it is in a friendly like this. And we also see that we saw some options for the replay. We could skip it. We could change the speed of the replay. But I felt like that was a good speed. Dale. We should be making. Creating a lot of chances. And creating a lot of goals. In this match. Not sure if that was a good chance though. 16 minutes played. Moving on to 19th minute. Maguire is going to score again. Nope, he missed. At least we are creating something now. It have happened in the past that I have lost matches like this. Doesn't really look very likely at this point, even if their goalkeeper is playing very well. We can see here, substitution, or this is changed a little bit, a much smaller substitutions. We have tactics, this button, and then we have select your match mentality, select team shape. Ah, team shape. Okay, we went to structured. Yeah, that's the team shape. Adjust or issue new instructions to your players. Let's have a look at that. Okay, that's the instructions. We do not have any instructions at the moment. And we have the youth team scoring a goal. McCourt to Bryson. Was there a mistake? It looks like we have it under control, but Cartwright completely gets bypassed. I think it was McCourt that was the real player, because we had one real player on this youth team. The others are not. We should be able to take the lead back before halftime, but not that time. Let's look at these tactics. Do we really get any info here? We get the average rating. I guess this is the energy they have, or condition. Oh. Come on. Overall physical condition, match sharpness. Everyone is low on match sharpness, of course. We can also see it by list. Interesting analysis. We can see where on the pitch things are happening. Looks like the youth team is pushing forward again, but we're gonna keep an eye on this. Best performance, Jarrett Rivers, the right winger on our team, rushing. Struggled to perform, Ryan Hutchinson, one of the central defenders. And we can see Leslie Bryson, the goal scorer on their team, is their best player. Updates. I guess this will be more important when you are playing league matches to have a look at this, but for now we're gonna move on to the pitch. And we can see that this is also changed. And we have half time. I guess I was talking. What should we do here in the half time? I guess we can go into here, but this should take us to team talk. Most of the players appear completely disinterested in what you have to. At least he could say something. We asked the assistant manager to take care of it, and it looks like it was positive. Should we make any changes? I don't really care for changes. We can just continue playing. For a moment, it looked like we were much stronger than the youth team, but we can see that they are creating chances now as well, and we both have two shots on target. That is not a good feeling after more than 60 minutes played. Come on, Rutherford, Cartwright. Will we steal that ball? No, we will not. Is this actually a highlight for the youth team? Nope, we take the ball back. That's good. From how this match looks, we need to make a lot of changes. Dale, you should be able to find someone. There we go. Rivers scores. We have 2-1, but it's not very impressive. It's not very impressive at all. I guess now is a good chance to make changes. There is where we make changes. Now we can see Rutherford, we need to change him. I actually had a little bit of a look. We can see Jordan Lydler. He is not a bad player. He's got 2 stars at the moment, 3 stars potential. Don't think he will be too bad. I guess we can change a midfielder as well. And Lewis Horner can come out. And Sean Reed or Dale Hobson. Let's put in Dale Hobson. And we should make a change here in the defensive line as well. Ryan Hutchinson is going to go out, and Jordan Watson is going to play instead. At least we made a few changes, nothing really special. A first friendly match against the youth team. And with 16 minutes left to play plus extra time, I feel like we should score two or three more goals. Maguire finally 3-1. Finally, we shouldn't need to worry about not winning this match. Let's see if we can have a look at some other. Okay, this is from the top here, data analyst. We didn't have time to check any other angles out, but I'm sure we will have a lot of time to look at that later on. Could we go for a fourth goal? Not this time. Instead, that is a great ball, Butler. It actually looks like he managed to pass the goalkeeper, but that shot is very, very wide. actually starting to wonder if 4-4-2 is really a good option to play, because it looks like there are a lot of holes on the field that our opponents are able to take advantage of. But I feel like with the how the team looked, we do not really have any other option at the moment. We could go and buy central midfielders. Nice goal, Maguire, and go with just one attacker. That might be a better option for the future. Maybe for next season we can have a look at that, or maybe for the January transfer window. So 4-1, we're gonna skip that. Looks like there will be 3 minutes of extra time and they will go by fast. And if I am correct, we will just have 8 seconds of highlight here in the end. Sometimes in Football Manager 2017, it could be 1 or 2 minutes of that last bit of highlight that went to the referee just blowing his whistle. That could be a bit annoying, but 8 seconds, I can live with that. And then Maguire, 3 goals. Jarrett Rivers was also strong with at least 1 goal and 1 assist. Actually, we can maybe have a look at that. Review. Where are actually the stats? I wanted to have a look at them. Team stats. Can't find them. So I guess we will push forward instead. So we have seen a few new things today. We have played one friendly, one practice match, and I feel like I should let the assistant manager take care of the other friendlies. We're gonna make sure of that now. Responsibilities for his team and manage friendlies. Darren Holloway will take care of them. Let's look at the schedule. We are going to play against Morton, Glasgow, Airdrie, Matlock, North Shields. And then the first match of the league will be against Alfreton, and then against York and Tamworth. I guess we will end the episode here. If anything happens that is of interest before the match against Alfreton, I will get back to you. Otherwise, I will see you when we reach the match against Alfreton. I guess we will show that the first match of the season that really matters. After that, we will pick some random matches that looks interesting in some way and play them live. Otherwise, I will play a bit on my own as well, because it is a very long season. A very, very long season. Next episode, we're gonna start the Vanarama North League play. Until then, I am Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.